Off the coast of South Wales, the Bristol Channel is shrouded in thick fog. Guarding these treacherous waters, Porthcawl Lifeboat Station. An emergency call's come in. The volunteers here are used to dealing with any crisis the sea can throw at them.
Fully dressed.
But today's different.
You're programmed to attend at the lifeboat station, put your gear on, and go out and rescue somebody at sea. It's not often you hear that you're going to rescue somebody fallen from a horse in a boat.
The only information the crew have is that a woman has been seriously injured while out riding.
Is at the muscle bed just past gear point.
The 20-year-old is on a remote beach 3 miles off the coast. She's too far from a road to reach by ambulance. In this fog, an airlift by helicopter would be too dangerous.
But guys, if it has the extraction, there's no aircraft available because of the viz, OK?
The only way to get her to hospital for urgent emergency care is by boat.
We were kind of the only option. A lump automatically appears in your throat to know that it comes down to you. You can't really get it wrong. You can't take your time. You just need to get there and get the job done.
Between the crew and the casualty lies one of the most dangerous headlands on their patch, Scare Point. To make matters worse, today they can barely see it.
Scare Point is an area that you treat with massive amounts of respect. It's an evil cocktail, if you like, of dangers. It's got needle-sharp rocks.
Big tides, fast-moving water. Some would use the word treacherous.
It's an area that try to avoid if you can.
The fog was so thick. It was really outside of our comfort zone.
We couldn't see a thing.
The other side, to the west, yeah?
Somebody was testing us.
You've got the end of the scare, yeah? Yeah, that's it. There's a guardian there as well.
Coast Guard and paramedics have got down to the remote beach on foot. Cold, wet, and in pain, Sophie, the rider, has already been examined by the medics. Her horse has been caught and led to safety.
All right.
But Sophie hasn't been so lucky.
Hello, Sophie.
She's come off horse.
Give us a sec. I'll have a chat with the paramedic, and then we'll get a plan to get you somewhere warm and dry, all right? Right.
In the mibs, mate.
My phone rang, and it was Sophie to say, I've had a disaster.
Okay.
Moby ran towards some rocks, right. And I've fallen off and I've hurt my left side.
Okay.
Then she started crying, and that's when I started thinking, what damage has she done? Everything was going through my mind. Did she break her leg, break her arm? She was never going to walk again. It's just frightened the life out of me, thinking the very, very worst.
Right.
It was when we learned that actually this is potentially a spinal injury with potentially life-changing injuries attached to it. Everything tends to slow down and you need to start to really think about what we're going to do and how we're going to do it.
What we're going to do then is take you on our boat.
Does
plan is...
Capsize me?
No, we're not going to be doing stuff like that, OK?
Sophie's been given drugs for the pain and strapped to a stretcher. If she's damaged her spine, any movement could leave her permanently injured.
Okay. Ready, brace, lower.
But now the crew have to get her and the paramedic onto a boat and out through the waves. While Simon stays with the casualty, Helmsman B gets extra hands from the bigger boat waiting offshore to help with the delicate manoeuvre.
This is what we need to do, OK? We need to go in. All you guys are going to be concerned with managing the boat, OK? I want you in the water, just holding and steadying the boat for us. Keep your eyes out for any rogue waves or any waves at all. Keep me informed all the time. Is it OK?
Yeah.
Understand?
Right. Yeah.
You stay as you are, and we just, as the boat is set at that angle there, that's exactly how we're going in, all right?
We had two people on board that really weren't used to being out at sea. One of them is completely immobilized.
The worst case scenario would be that we encounter some large surf and the boat go over.
Okay, so the brief I've given to the paramedic is, if it goes over, we'll worry about the casualty. He needs to worry about himself, so stay with the boat or a lifeboatman, okay?
It's all about risk versus benefit. Is the benefit worth taking the risk? And in this situation, when you're told that there is no other option, there's no other way of extracting this person safely and comfortably, then yeah, it was worth the risk.
Keep going. Keep going.
Steady, steady, Eddie. Steady, Eddie.
You all right?
We don't have your hat.
So I am your captain, and everything is going to be fine, trust me, okay?
All right, if we can just turn her head towards my left, towards the starboard side of the boat. Right, excellent.
There we are.
Been all right, right. Paramedic, if we get the paramedic on the bow here. Don't worry, mate. Right, it's just to keep you dry, all these bags. Okay, don't worry.
The crew must now navigate the riskiest part of the evacuation.
Just hold us here, guys. Just let this settle down for a second, OK?
Standing between Sophie and safety is the breaking surf.
You're telling her everything is going to be OK. You will be fine.
OK, step away, guys, step away.
What you're actually thinking is, please let it be calm. Please let there be no waves. Please let this be OK.
Sure.
There's always an element of doubt. But you can't show them that.
If we got a little wave, I'll just... We're not gonna... No, don't worry, that won't happen. Right, there's another little wave. Another one more. Are you okay, so? You okay? That's all right, okay. It's all right, mate, you're all right. There you go, that's perfect. Well done. You're all right. You're all right, mate. Well done. That's the worst part. That's it. We're good now. How you doing? I know.
I feel comfortable.
Okay, we're getting out now. We're going on to the big boat now.
Nothing is going to happen to you now, okay? You're absolutely fine. There's far too much paperwork involved to let anything happen to you now.
B and the crew face one final hurdle, heaving Sophie onto the larger, faster lifeboat to get her to medical attention as soon as possible.
Well done, Soph.
Right. Well done, mate. Goodness me. Mate, I'm just going to try and tuck you in a bit. Okay. All right. I know you're probably soaking wet and thinking, what's he talking about?
20-year-old Sophie has been riding for 8 years. She was galloping her horse, Moby, along the beach when she lost control. The accident was caught on Sophie's own camera.
Well, 1 minute I'm on Moby, next minute I'm on the floor, crying, soaking wet, and then the next minute I'm going onto a lifeboat, so it was just... I just couldn't believe what was going on. Never had no problems with them. We've gone hacking, never any problems. We had a canter through the sand dunes, went into a gallop, and after a couple of seconds, I felt like, oh, I don't have him anymore. It's one of the worst feelings I think I've ever been through. If the RNLI hadn't come, I literally don't know what would have happened.
Your pain is still the same?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not getting worse, so...
No.
OK. Anything else?
Just cold.
Just cold, I know.
They were so friendly. They were, like, making me laugh, just making me feel comfortable.
We're nearly home, mate. We've got about 10 minutes now, OK?
Back at Porthcawl, an ambulance is waiting to take Sophie for the final leg of her journey to hospital.
There you go, Soph. All the best, mate. We'll see you soon, all right? You take care.
Grab yourself, Soph, OK?
They've rescued my daughter. Oh, she could have died. They did a fantastic job.
This is one of those jobs that you do lose sleep over. You do go through the what-ifs, because if it had gone wrong, it would have gone very wrong. To get back to the lifeboat station is always a relief after a job like that.